Welcome to the 10 best features of OmniTrader 2023 with your host, Ed Downs. Thanks so much for coming, folks, to watch my presentation on OmniTrader 2023. Just came out of the oven, as they say, and man, this thing is fabulous. Our staff has added so many great features into the software. Quite a few of them were from user requests, but then we added a couple of our own power tools that I'm sure you're going to really like when you see them. All right, let's just dive right in here and get down to it. Okay. Here is the list of the 10 features. I'm going to cover each of them very quickly and explain to you why I think they're so powerful for the software. And those that I've highlighted in red are actually my favorites, so I'll spend a little more time on them. All right, without any further ado, let's get started. Let's start by talking about favorites, because all of us have indicators that we use a lot. And typically what you have to do is hit right click, you know, add indicator, and then go through all of these, find it, click it. If you have a lot of plugins installed, of course you have a big long list down here. So now what you can do is go right to chart options and tell the program which are your favorites. And then they're very easy to get to. So let's say we have, I've got Bollinger Bands I just checked here. Here is the ADX. You can also double click, edit it, and set, if I activate it here, I can edit it and set the values for the Bollinger Bands to anything I want. And of course they will be saved in this item here. All right, so but I can go down and let's say I want to do relative strength, something I use a lot, relative strength index, just find it down here alphabetically. It's right there, it's a favorite that. I happen to like, let's see, another one, Coral Trend is another favorite I have that I use a lot. And also Donchian Channel Direction. So those are those four or five, but you can pick, you know, as many as you want. You close this, and now when I go to right click, add indicator, I'm gonna see favorites. And there they are, Coral Trend. Boom, it's on. So that's as easy as that is. Let's add some Bollinger Bands. Right click, add indicator, favorites, right there, and Bollinger Bands. So much quicker and easier than going through the indicator menu. So that's just one of those great features that everybody here really, really appreciates in this upgrade. And I'm sure you will too. Okay, so real quick, let's look at a couple of toolbar enhancements that were made to the chart toolbars. There's two of them, chart date and chart periods. And what I'm gonna do is grab the chart date toolbar here and pull it up so we can sort of focus on it. And I'm going to move the date to the left somewhere. All right, so I'll go over here, I'm looking at something, whatever it is. And let's say, you know, December. And now I want to go back to the right edge. Well, I could drag this over there. We have a new button that just goes there. So that's the fast forward to the right edge, and there's the right edge. You also have the left edge, if you want to do that, which would go all the way to the left. You want to go to the start of the data and then scroll from there. So end of the, you know, right edge and then first bar of data. So that's just a nice little shortcut on the date, chart date toolbar. The other one, which is really useful, is chart periods. Because a lot of times, you know, this 3, 6, 9, 12 months has been there forever, since the beginning of the software. And people typically want something maybe different, like 1 month is a common usage, maybe 2 months. What I can do is take one of these buttons and just redefine it that way. So if I shift click, it will say, what do you want that to be? And I'm going to say, I want it to be 1 month. Okay. And now the toolbar is set to 1 month, and that's what it will do. If I click it, so here's all the data, 1 month. So that's just a nice way to customize that so I can get exactly what I want when I'm looking at my charts. Okay, so here we're going to talk about a true power tool for OmniTrader, useful for many, many things, but especially for finding stocks or ETFs that are related to a specific symbol. And that relation is called correlation. Because what you can do is if you find a bunch of symbols that are related, say, to the energy group, then when the energy group is becoming bullish, you can find exactly which stocks to trade with that group that are moving with it or in unison to it. You can also find the ones that have not moved as much as the others, but are nevertheless correlated to that one symbol. So the energy symbol that I want to look at is called XLE. We're going to put that in, we're going to see it come up. XLE, this is the SPDR Select Sector Fund for Energy. The Energy Select Sector is what this is. And if we look at it, we see that it's breaking out through a pattern. I'm going to turn my chart patterns off here so we see a little bit better. It's breaking through these highs right here and moving up rapidly. So we want to find other stocks that are related to this sector for trading. So what I do is I hit Tools, Correlation Tool, and that brings up this new feature in OmniTrader 2023. So I want to put XLE here, and I'm going to say to correlate that or compare it to all optionable US stocks. So I put that in here and I'm ready to go. All I do now is say go, and what it's going to do is analyze all of the optional US stocks and give me a list of the most highly correlated stocks to that energy sector ETF. All right, let's go ahead and let that run for a second here and then we'll look at the symbols. Okay, so I now have my list, and you can see the highest correlated to XLE is AMPY, followed by AMR, APA, and so on. And it goes on down here, if I look at the scroll bar, all the way down to low correlation. Okay, so what I can do is get, let's say, the 80 and above into a list. I went into OmniScan and created a My Symbols list called XLE Correlated Stocks, so I could do this. So now I'm just going to click on these guys over here. Say shift click on that one, which will highlight all of them. Then I copy and put these into the list. Right click, paste symbols. And there they are. Okay, I can close the correlation tool. And here are the symbols then that are the most correlated to this. So I can bring them up one at a time and just see. And you can see Amgen, for example, is taking off. It's moving up. It's related to that group. Here's Amplify Energy, also taking off, very highly correlated to the ETF. This one's a nice one, AMR, which has moved up and is going sideways, taking off. Now, not all of these will be in the energy sector. This is a metallurgical resources stock, but they're correlated to it. So that's the thing. We want diversification, realizing that for some reason, internally in the market, these stocks are correlated to the energy sector. So they're gonna be great candidates. Here's a good pullback to the Bollinger Band there, with my curl trend taking off a little bit. Here's one that's about to break through the top here. Anyway, really great power tool in OmniTrader 2023. And the other thing I didn't mention is there are correlation settings in here that you can change. So there's quite a few different things you can do. This is looking at the backtest period. You can look at correlation on a specific date or as of, you know, today, whatever is actually correlated today. And it will look then at, from that date, whatever you say, so many bars and so many segments. So you can actually have it look at, let's say, you know, 5 or 10 different segments of time, and it will look at correlation in each of those segments. So, you know, that is a way to just get a smoothed out correlation over a lot of time. These are very good defaults, but you have that flexibility to get a more tight correlation measurement if you want to use that. So again, fantastic feature. Glad they got it in. It's really useful for finding stocks to trade, and just want to say kudos to the team for the new correlation tool. Now let's talk about using ATS or ATM in real time with AutoTrade. ATS stands for Automatic Trade Selection, and that was actually added into OmniTrader several versions ago, and it has to do with automatic trade selection based on a portfolio method. So if I click my toolbar up here, I'll see the ones that are pretty much included with every OmniTrader that goes out, and you can pick different ones to run in the portfolio simulation. That's what these are for. And then one that you're actually using right now. So those are the ATS methods. If you have ATM installed, which stands for Automatic Trade Management, that is a huge system supporting market states and concurrent trading and allocation methods and all of these. I won't go into ATM, but if you have it, you know how powerful that is. So either ATS or ATM is enhanced by this feature. What is the feature? Hey, you can run them in real time now. That's right. Any one of these methods or any ATM method with market states, allocation, ranking, all those things that ATM does, specific strategies for specific lists, all those things can run in real time. Big deal with this version. Okay, so if you're running in real time, AutoTrade, and this is the next thing we're going to talk about, is you're going to want to select one of those methods to actually run. So you would say method, and then you would pick the one that you want to run. Let's say reversal, whatever it is. And again, it can be ATS or ATM. So this is now supported in real time for AutoTrade. That's the first big feature I want to tell you about related to just the support of it. But then the other thing is, in real time, you know, ATM and ATS were originally built around end of day charts, and so it's been fine up till now, but in real time, these signals are appearing as bars are coming in because it's analyzing. And so what AutoTrade would do by default up until this version of OmniTrader is it would wait for all the analysis to be completed, which seems natural. You want to choose between different signals, but that was very appropriate for end of day, not so much for real time. In real time, as soon as a signal is generated, you want to trade it, like right now. So they added this checkbox down here with the change to support real time, and that is trade as soon as possible. So as soon as a signal is generated, a new signal, it can be traded using this ATS or ATM method in real time. Huge advancement to the software if you're doing anything in real time, or if you want to work with some of our strategies and maybe just paper trade them in real time with an ATM method, ATS method, see how they do. So it's just a tremendous thing, and super proud of the folks for actually supporting real-time trading with this powerful, powerful portfolio management software. All right. Another important feature of AutoTrade is the new alert function. There's actually a new button down here that says alerts. And if you've been AutoTrading in any way, especially to a broker, you know that we send emails when certain things happen. End of day and real time, and they're different. So this is a real time profile, but end of day, we would tell you that the to-do list had run and also that orders had been submitted to the broker, or if you disconnected from the broker and reconnected. So we would send you emails every time that happened and you had no choice. They just came to you. The idea was you need to know, but now you have a choice. You can actually uncheck those alerts. This is in real time. End of day, you can uncheck these if you want to. So you can only get exactly the emails that you want. But then we added some new ones. So if a new position is entered, you can get an alert for that in your email. A vote line, exit and open position. So, you know, to make sure the vote line's matching your positions if you want to check that. And there are rare cases where it may get out of sync, depending on the internet, things that can happen. So that could be good. The trade plan has completed, you've exited your position, and so on. Of course, disconnect broker and disconnect data feed. So all those things can now come to you in an email at your option by checking those buttons or those checkboxes there. All right, so that was a really good improvement on this. And again, the focus being able to auto trade any strategies with any ATM ATS method in real time and getting notified as things occur. Okay, well now I want to talk about, I was going to say my favorite feature. I have a lot of favorite features in this upgrade, but this one is really big for me. I've been wanting this for so long in the software, and I finally got it. And I don't know how many of y'all are using TWS with OT. I really enjoy doing it. Let me go ahead and bring it up here. Okay, there it is. And you see I've got a lot of trades going on here. Today's a pretty bullish day in the market, so did some positions in real time, but so here's the interface for the Trader's Workstation, and you know, typically what you end up doing is bringing it up to look at it to see the stats that are in here and, you know, things like open orders and all that kind of stuff, because this is where it is. We have some integration, or we had some integration to TWS, like to get the, you know, the current profit loss level percentage and that sort of thing, but you couldn't see all of this information. Well, now, thanks to the work of my team, minimize that. It is in OmniTrader. So if I go to the portfolio in OT and open positions, I now see them in here. We did not have this before. You had to go to TWS to get this. We also have open orders. And you can see, like right now, on the QQQ, I've got a stop market right there. And that is going to be also in here under open orders, right there. Stop market on QQQ. And I've got another one on Nike. Go to that chart, and you can see it right there. The other thing is, if I go to open positions, and this is also super convenient, you notice I have one click traversal. So I click it, it shows the chart, and I can use page down to go through these. Look at this. Isn't that fantastic? Yeah, really, really, really great. Okay, and I can even go in here and make an adjustment right now. Let's see what's my most profitable entry. It's got to be this one right here on V. And so I can say, this is an end of day chart, of course, but I can say, all right, if we drop down through, I don't know, there, Go ahead and place that, you know, that order, and there it is on V. So fantastic, fantastic improvement to OmniTrader integrated with the trader's workstation. Thanks, guys. So here's a feature that is one of those things that when you know you need it, you just need it, okay? So data feeds and brokers have different symbols for different things. It's very, very common. And so how you get data from feed A and trade it with broker B, and in our case, typically that's Interactive Brokers. Well, now there is a file that we look at in the software where we can translate between two symbols. For example, if your data feed, in this example here, your data feed provides the data for crude oil as QMCL, but the broker, Interactive Brokers, trades the symbol MCL. They're the same thing, different symbols. So you can put a translation in this file that says, for QMCL, which is a futures contract, trade MCL. Or some services have a dot in front of the symbol. So if you want to trade dot AAPL, which is a stock, trade AAPL at the broker instead. That's one use of the symbol translation. The other is, if you're analyzing one thing and wanting to trade another, the example here is analyzing the full crude oil futures contract, which has very high margin, but trading the micro instead. And the reason you do that is because the full contract is much more liquid, it's better for analysis, but the micro tends to really follow it pretty well. So we want to trade the micro, less margin, but analyze the full contract. So that's what this is. So you've got for the symbol CL futures, you want to trade MCL. Okay, so again, very, very simple translation, and those are two uses, and they're common, especially if you're trading futures, but also if you're using any data feed that does not have the same symbol format as OmniTrader or the broker that you're trading with. Okay, so the last special feature I want to just tell you about is this utility function that was added around the portfolio simulator. And so y'all are very familiar with this curve. What we wanted to do, and we have wanted to do this for quite a while, is to analyze the data on this curve. So like get the actual values of the curve out of it into a spreadsheet. And so now there is a new spreadsheet being generated by the software in the ATM log folder. And I can just bring it up here. It's actually the equity. This is percent of equity was the method I ran, and it's the equity dump, which is of course a dump of the values. And so if I bring the spreadsheet up here, I've got dates for every point in that equity curve and the value of the equity curve. Okay, so I go down here, go through the whole thing down to the bottom of it and get all those values and then say insert a graph, one of those guys, and boom, there it is. So this is the same thing you see, except it's data that I can analyze. So I can look at, you know, different retracement levels or whatever I want to do with it. We have been using this feature to combine different time frames together, because once you get it with Excel, you can say to, you know, take two columns and converge them based on the dates being the same. So it's been very useful to us. It's something that was added, and we went ahead and formalized it as a feature for anyone who gets the 2023 upgrade. So with all of that, I think you can clearly see that OmniTrader 2023 definitely gives you the advantage in your trading with all of these amazing features, starting with our TWS tight integration into OmniTrader's portfolio, the favorites menu, so you can quickly get to the systems and indicators that you use the most often. Then there's ATS ATM in real time with the fast trade feature. We also have an equity curve report, so you can analyze the equity curve. Then there's fast portfolio charting, bringing up charts one at a time very quickly from that portfolio list. Correlation tool, really big deal. This is a way you can find stocks that are moving with the industry groups or the other stocks that you're interested in trading. So you can either get a portfolio established or a jump based on the relative movement of those symbols. Then there's the email alerts. You can be alerted to pretty much anything that happens with the computer, the market, the broker, whatever, and of course, so much more. So that's OmniTrader 2023. It's an amazing piece of software, tremendous amount of work went into it. And I just want to close this webinar by saying thank you.
You know, we have been the trading software company that has focused on trading automation since 1995. That's over 25 years. And I know that's why you love our company. We really appreciate you, your business, and we're here to help you continue to tackle the markets and meet your investment and trading goals. So again, thank you so much. Ready to get OmniTrader 2023? Want to go to that website down there, nirvanasystems.com/OT23. Let OmniTrader 2023 empower you to engage the markets in 2023 and beyond. Thanks, folks. Take care.